No, none of y'all motherfuckers here with no Instagram, nobody living, nobody at, and I don't want to hear from none of these Jewish talk about, oh, he's in an episode. These, you know what I'm saying? I'm on my Farrakhan Don right now, bro.
Kanye West is back, baby, doing some high-level satire that we mortals can never hope to understand. Or it is possible he is in the grips of another episode, hate to be the one to say it, and he is turning into anti-Semitic Kanye once again, rare form. You kind of forget that he's there, and then he just ends up giving some kind of diatribe like this at a listening party, album listening party in Las Vegas. During the event, West revealed he'd added another anti-Semitic line into his new music. Quote, I still keep some Jews with me. Management? Nah, I only let them do my jewelry. God, he's such a visionary. Anyway, so he went on a rant about Jews, quote, controlling schools and hospitals. And once again praised Adolf Hitler. A little on the nose if you ask me. Take a look.
The mother pilgrims, it's a Jewish, they dress the same. It's the same, that's the story. They put us in the school, the Rothschilds. We don't have to bow to this. Okay, it's 60 million of us in America, 60 million Jews in the world. 50% of our deaths is abortion. 25% of us go to prison. Raise one hand if you don't know one prison, one locked up, and one poor. Wait, raise your hand if you don't know one person got abortion. Now I tell you, if it was in a Jewish mother on Friday with no, everybody raised their hands. So, but wait a second. But who got? But wait a second. Who make the hospitals though? Who got the hospitals? These are Zionists. This is what I'm trying to tell you. Jesus Christ, Hitler, yay, third party sponsor that.
Who would sponsor that? Jesus Christ, Hitler, yeah, you just see Jesus in the corner going, no, I'm not with him. I mean, my body, my blood is like 14% alcohol according to the priest on Sunday when you gotta drink it, but I'm not that drunk. There's an amazing image. He also wore a black KKK hood during a listening party in Miami earlier this week. He's getting around. And while wearing that KKK style hood on stage, he rapped, quote, God, I'll never do it justice. How I'm anti-Semitic, just effed a Jewish B. Which really is a get out of jail free card when it comes to anti-Semitism. Take it from me, half a Jew. So it's one of those decision points, guys. I gotta be honest. For me, it's a decision point. Do I do this jokingly? Obviously, I've made that decision. I would like to say in the grips of what's happening on the international stage, I just ask that everybody ask themselves one question in all of this. Kanye said a lot of stuff. Those are classic anti-Semitic tropes. Are you saying things kind of like Kanye West at this point? How many, you know, you've heard of 30 seconds to Mars. Are you 30 seconds to Kanye? If so, go back. Realize how ridiculous you sound. And please, I just wonder what would possess some. There's people in. It might be just a cadence, call and response, like instinctive thing when he says like, "Who runs the hospitals?" Which is just a nonsense rhetorical question. And someone goes, mm. Like like the guy on the Daily who has those little thought gasms. Like, that's really interesting. No, it's nonsense.
Yeah.
What do you think, people?
So look, I'm torn on two fronts. One is it's so absurd, it's hard not to laugh at the absurdity, right? And on the other hand, it's so serious, the crazy stuff he's saying, the hatred that he's driving. And on the one hand, he's so vile that I want to, you know, rhetorically rip his head off. And on the other hand, he's obviously mentally ill, right? So it's so hard to know how to treat this guy. But okay, let's talk about why it's absurd. Who controls the hospital? Why is that a bad thing? If the Jews have brought us hospitals, I'd like to thank the Jews.
Already a bad, it's such a bad alley to go down. Don't talk, don't go down there. That's a trope.
Is that even a trope? I thought he made that up.
No,
why would that even be a bad thing? Look at all the doctors they've brought to save our lives. Like, what is that? And I thought the Indians ran the hospitals.
Those are tropes. Tropes are like, are you a good Jew or are you a bad Jew? Or are you a person who's saying the good thing? Are you one of the Jews is on our side or the Jews are on the bad other side? This is a whole thing happens with like African American things where it's like, don't make me speak for everybody. Don't like see if I'm a good one or a bad one. Like it's a trope with people who have historically been underserved and marginalized. No one wants to speak for everyone. It's just rough. But yeah, it's like it's just like he's spouting nonsense.
But is that like serious question? I have never heard that. Is that a thing that the Jews control the hospitals?
I forget what show I was watching, but it's like when they're talking to a Jew, it's like a Gentile talking to a Jew, and it's like, and I just so you know, we always when it comes to picking a doctor, we look for the Jewish name. That's a
joke. Oh, so that's a thing. Okay, yeah. Jesus Christ, man. People find different ways to be anti-Semitic. And the prison line, I didn't understand the prison line. There's a lot of African Americans in prison. There's a giant problem. We've talked about that endlessly in terms of how to fix it, criminal justice reform. What does that have to do with Jews? What are you talking about? What insanity is coming out of your mouth? And then he's like, yeah, you know, the good guys are Jesus, Hitler, and yay. Already insanity in every part of that. But also, Jesus is Jewish.
Yep.
Like, but that's so that leads to the back to the other question that I asked. Like, what do you do with this guy? On the one hand, if you don't point out how vile and disgusting it is, then it just sits there. And I know that whenever anything sits there, it festers, right? So you gotta knock it down. On the other hand, it's so obvious that he's mentally ill. And so where's the line between incredibly vile and mentally ill? And if you say, well, look, he's a genius artist, I don't care at all. Like that doesn't move me 1%. And I'm so sick of people saying that. I don't give a how good he is in music or not good. I don't care. It's like saying, well, on the other hand, I thought Hitler was actually a pretty good artist. I don't care. That's not the relevant part. Okay, so earlier in Kanye's career, the relevant part was his music. Now the relevant part is he has lost his mind and he's trying to drive hatred towards a specific group. And it's disgusting. And if you don't realize that Kanye's disgusting, sorry, but there's something deeply wrong with you. This is not close, it's not around the edges. He's all the way at talking about how great Hitler is. Not close, okay? So you're not, if you're agreeing with any of it or trying to excuse it in any way, shape or form, yeah, you're 30 seconds away from him and you're 30 seconds away from going, yay Hitler. That's an awful, awful place to be. Kanye and his music. So I think I was clear enough, go ahead.
Yeah, no ambiguity there. You know, the conversation always around, oh, we gotta separate the art from the artist. This is somebody who is past that point. They've made it perfectly clear who they are, what they think, what they believe. And as someone who really liked his first several albums, it's just like, there's no point. I can't get past what he's saying and what he's doing, even from a couple years ago. I would encourage other people to do the same. Also, the people who are around him, the people who are on the next album or worked on his next album, which could come out soon, and the people in that room. There was a really interesting moment in that video where he kind of acknowledges that many of the people in that room are people he's paying. So what are you doing with your life? Where you have to sit there and like nod along the yeah, yeah, totally, the Jews control the hospitals for a paycheck. Like there are other jobs out there, I promise you. They're probably more interesting than that, than catering to his ego. I would encourage you to just distance yourself, and especially all the rappers who are on this upcoming album, who have verses or help produce it. Don't work with him anymore, because you're gonna blow up your career.
Yeah, I was gonna say one last thing about that. Look, Hitler was probably also mentally ill, so that's why it's an even tougher issue. Like, what do you do with someone who's mentally ill but causing great harm, right? But Jordan makes a great point. The people around him have no excuse. Okay, maybe he's mentally ill. What's your excuse? Oh, I was gonna collect a paycheck for helping him promote the worst, most violent anti-Semitic propaganda. Well, I hope you're proud. So no, if you're in that room and you're not walking out, you're disgusting.
Yeah, I just want everybody to be on the lookout for like, are you invoking any anti-Semitic tropes in these times? There's only one thing that he said that was accurate in his video. We're not gonna go to the video, but he did talk trash about Sierra Canyon. And as a proud alumnus of Chatsworth Hills, they were our Rinaldi rivals and they do suck, and Kanye's right about that. I don't care how many LeBron James kids go there, but they suck. That said, I do think like There are 100 million people in the world who are probably like, well, listen, he's saying it in a crazy way, but I do believe these things about the Jews. I do believe that they are running the monetary policy of the world. I do believe that they run the entertainment industry. I do believe that they're doing all these horrible things behind the scenes. Like, I hear it. I hear it all the time. I see it in people's faces. It sucks. And it is on all of us to ask ourselves if we are doing any of these tropes. Like, his is a magnified version, but if you've got it in there, if along the way in your discourse on Israel you end up being like, oh God, I just kind of said something about Jews that was kind of like something Kanye West said, that is a serious reason for actually doing this story. Don't do it, because there's plenty of places to have a decent conversation, and I respect and thank everybody for doing that on behalf of all Jews, because if I'm the token one, you know, I'm not that Jewish, but I'll take it. I made the ultimate sacrifice.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.